What's up, everybody? My name is Dwight, and welcome back to GeForce Garage. Since our Turing announcement in August, we've shown a good number of builds that feature the new graphics cards, but we have yet to put an RTX 2080 Ti on water. So what's a better way than to visit water cooling expert Jay's Two Cents to show us how it's done? So we're here in sunny Southern California with Jay's Two Cents himself, who has been doing a ton of overclocking on the 20 series cards to the extent where you're actually Frankensteining your own cards to beat people in an overclocking competition that you've been doing.
Yeah, when these cards come out, they don't typically have a block available to it immediately. So we had to kind of come up with our own solutions, and that's what we did here. Not the prettiest, but definitely gets the job done.
Yeah. But now we have a set of the EK Vector RTX 2080 Ti blocks, and we're gonna be doing that inside of your legendary Skunkworks PC.
This is the centerpiece of my channel. It's designed to grow as the channel grows. There's nothing practical about it. It's a little big and over the top, kind of like me. And obviously with the new graphics card launch, it was perfect time for me to kind of do a complete overhaul, and we're gonna top it off today with the 20 series, obviously.
Nice, and then what did you upgrade to?
So now we have an X299 with a 7960X. We're gonna have the same 64 gigs of Dominator Special Edition in there. We've got the new EK Velocity RGB block, and then the rest of it, all the water cooling stays the same. Coolstream RADs, this is the PE, top and bottom. Of course, it's all crammed into a Case Labs SMA8, which is a little bit more nostalgic now than it was, considering, unfortunately, the company is no longer producing cases. And so I'm kind of excited to update this and start playing on it again.
I haven't had the honor of water cooling a 20 series card yet. I've done plenty of 10 series and a bunch before that as well. So I'm really curious to see how you go about doing this because it is a new shroud design.
Yeah, and I'm curious too because it's my first time doing it the right way. So here's a new 2080 Ti RTX card from NVIDIA. This is a Founders Edition card. The new Founders 2080 Ti looks great, but obviously we're gonna be water cooling this today using the EK Vector block specifically meant for the 2080 Ti. So the first thing we have to do is actually remove the backplate off of our Founders Edition card. And to do that, we are gonna remove all of these small silver Phillips head screws from the backplate. Now before removing the four larger screws surrounding the core right here, you need to remove these two screws that are closer to the actual PCIe bracket. These are gonna be a little bit larger. Now that we've done that, we can go ahead and remove the four spring-loaded screws on the back of the backplate. Now we're gonna remove the three larger black screws that are on the PCIe bracket. Okay, now that all of those screws are loose, we're gonna go ahead and peel our backplate off. But before we do that, you need to be careful because there are some wire connections underneath here. So you don't wanna rip it apart too quickly. You sort of wanna wiggle it back and forth. And as you can see, you also have some thermal pads that are on the backplate. So you wanna be mindful of those and where they went. And now that we've got the backplate off, you can see that there are 4mm standoff bolts that are holding the cooler to the PCB. So those have to go next. Now I recommend starting from the portion around the core, the four that are on the middle of the card, and then working your way outward from there. Now it's important to keep in mind while doing this, there are a ton of SMCs on the back of this PCB. So you wanna be careful, take your time and be gentle so you don't accidentally break one of these off. So once all the back screws are removed, you're ready to separate the cooler. Now you wanna be careful because there is a connector on the back of the card right here and there's not a lot of slack. So be very gentle, wiggle it back and forth. And when it comes apart, there's one connector on the back of the PCB and there's not a lot of slack on that. So you wanna be very careful. Reach in there with either your fingers or a piece of plastic. Once you do that, the card is ready to accept its water block. All right, so now we gotta clean this PCB and get it ready for the water block. So I just peel off all of the thermal pads. Some are gonna stick to the cooler, some are gonna stick to the card. I basically just stick them wherever they go, back on the cooler in case for some reason I ever have to replace this cooler back on the card. So we're gonna use some isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol, and we are going to now clean off as much of this thermal material as we can. If it gets all over the sides, don't freak out. This is a non-conductive thermal paste that's used from the factory. It just gets a little bit messy. We also are gonna remove any of this blue stuff. We want this to be as clean as possible, so when we apply our new thermal paste, it's all fresh. So now that the core is all clean, we're gonna go ahead and hit the areas that we're gonna be applying thermal pads to. So we wanna clean off the chokes. We wanna do a little bit of alcohol on each one of the memory modules, that way the thermal pads can stick. We're gonna do the same thing on the back of the PCB as well. Because there were thermal pads back here, there's going to be thermal grease left behind. So you just wanna gently wipe off any of the shiny spots. But again, be mindful of all these semiconductors on the back. You don't wanna damage anything on the PCB. So for these cards, we're gonna be using not only the EK Vector water block, which is a full cover block, we're also gonna be using one of the EK backplates. And inside there, you're gonna find all your thermal pads, all your screws, and then you need to follow the QR code for the actual installation manual. One of the things that's different here with the new Vector series from EK is the way the flow works through the block. So instead of all of the flow going one direction through the core, it now goes directly down on the hottest part of the core and then splits off from there around the memory as well as around the VRM or the power delivery. So you're getting a very good high flow rate with a very efficient design in terms of flow. You have one wire that actually runs up to the manifold right here, as well as another wire that comes up and connects to your actual RGB header. So you wanna make sure that these are not going to be in the way as you're test fitting this on your graphics card. So you're gonna find three different sets of thermal pads here. One's a 1 millimeter thick, which will be used on the power delivery. And then you have some individually cut thermal pads here that are specifically for the memory modules. Once your thermal pads are in place, you need to make sure that you peel off the protective blue backing material. This, if you leave it on, will cause you overheating problems. It's easier to take something pointy like a razor blade and just sort of scrape it. And then once it comes off, you can just peel the rest. So now we need to take this single thermal pad and we need to cut it basically into four strips. We're gonna be applying it to these chokes, and then the MOSFETs next to them on either side. So we have to take this one strip and cut it into four. And then just like on the memory, make sure you remove all of the blue backing material. Otherwise the thermal pads won't do their job. Take the included thermal paste and we're gonna apply it in the X method with the cross. As you can see right here on the screen, this is exactly how they recommend that it be applied. So in this case, that's what we are gonna be doing. So two things, this is why I used the box, because we're gonna flip the PCB onto the block instead of the other way around. Otherwise we can't see the holes to line it up. The other thing is, remember that wire I mentioned earlier? You wanna make sure this is sort of routed down and out of the way. You can't leave this just chilling up here in this area because it could interfere on some of these components right here on the back of the board. So once our wire is out of the way and we're all set up on our box, we can go ahead and then just slowly turn this over and line it up with our graphics card. Because we're using EK backplates, we can't just start screwing down our block, otherwise we might need to remove some of our screws. So using the backplate, we're gonna reference which screws we're gonna be leaving empty while applying the PCB to the water block. Starting with the four screws right around the GPU core, tighten these down in a star pattern and then work your way out from there. Now in this corner of the PCB right here, the part closest to the motherboard and the outside of the case, you're gonna be using a screw and a nut because there's no standoff to screw into. So just place the screw through the hole, kind of line up the nut underneath, and then you can just tighten it down finger tight. Now we're almost ready to apply the back plate, but we have to prepare that with thermal pads as well. So we're gonna cut off one 1-inch by 1-inch square. This is going to be applied to the very center of the core cutout for the back plate, right there. And then there are two raised areas on the back plate that touch the backside of the MOSFETs on the PCB. So it's these two areas right here. So you're gonna cut strips out of the thermal pads, very similar to how we did it on the PCB, and then we can put the backplate in place. So the backplate includes their own set of hardware, including these plastic washers. Now these washers are very important. You wanna make sure the backplate doesn't ground out anywhere on the back of this PCB. So once you get all of these washers in place, move the backplate into place and tighten it down. Okay, so last but not least, we got to do something with this wire. And this is gonna be dependent on your case. If you've got a vertical mount, then you're gonna wanna kinda tuck it out of the way, maybe behind the card, zip tie it. In our case, it's gonna be very traditional layout like this. So I'm just gonna sort of push it back up underneath the clear cover where it won't be seen and out of sight and out of mind. And just like that, we've applied a new EK Vector full cover water block to our GeForce RTX 2080 Ti. So if you're running a multi-card setup, you would just do that whole process on both of your cards, like I did here. So next thing we gotta do now is get these installed into Skunkworks.
Okay, so we're back and it's all put together and it looks fantastic, honestly. I love the UV.
It turned out a lot better than I thought it was going to. I mean, a lot better than this. I mean, this worked, but yeah, it wouldn't have looked great in there, but I think it looks fantastic. Obviously the blocks perform well. They look great, but more importantly, it's about how well they perform. And then tying in like little things that people don't really think about, like sleeved cables. The UV green on these Cable Mod cables ties perfectly with the fluid. This little S-bend, you know, kind of bothered me, the idea of it at first when I was doing it. And now it's one of my favorite features. But that's kind of the whole point of Skunkworks, right? This is not a build to kind of show off and be like, hey, look how custom this is. Because it's really not that custom. It's basic hand tools, a heat gun to bend the tubes, screwdrivers, drill bits. It's nothing that you can't find in the average garage. You can have an amazing looking system like this without any sort of special or formal training to do it.
Well, thank you very much for your time. You gave us a valuable lesson on how easy it is to water cool GPUs now.
Well, no, thank you for the graphics cards, because I am going to do a lot of gaming on this.
Okay, well, we'll get out of your hair so you can start installing some games.
Excellent, thank you. Thanks for coming by.
Yeah. If you want to see more of Skunkworks, be sure to give JS 2 Cents a follow. There'll be a link down below. And if you want us to collaborate with any other tech YouTuber, just let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you for the next one.